here we are. MV Padula, a Padula bass. And someone Padula'd it, and I don't know. A couple people need a slap, and then I just shake my head and I'll tell the story. Okay, as I've come to realize, not too long ago, Padula is gone. Mike retired. Okay. But they produced this really cool owner's manual, which is very detailed. But there's some weird stuff about this. And I like I said, I had to actually bring over my good friend, mentor, fellow guitar repair person, extraordinaire, Mike Z, to look at this with me, because we really both could not believe what we were seeing. Well, we did see it, so just stand by and we'll look at it all together. Oh, we blew our O-ring here on the output jack. I hate those output jacks. Sorry, Mike. Sorry, Mike Padula. I hate those things. They're shit. Replaced more of those than anything. Let's go through your manual. Let's maybe zoom in a bit so everybody can read along with me. I don't know. Does anybody still read? Alright. So, they talk about the whole electronic pile of schwas. You know, and I'm sure there's a leaky battery in the back of it as we speak. But he signs it and everything. Then we get into battery adjustments. Strings, okay, recommended string gauges for 6, 5, 45, nice strings, bit. Right, then we get into the neck adjustment truss rod. This is where my jaw sort of dropped. Does anybody know what that is? What that really is? That is not a truss rod wrench. That is a dulcimer tuning wrench. Look it up if you don't know what a dulcimer is. It sounds like somebody shoved a stick up a cat's ass even when it isn't tuned. But that's the truss rod wrench, right? So I've never seen that. It's a square adjustment. Square, not hex. Okay. Oh, well, that was the weapon they chose. This is like, I looked this up on Reverb, that somebody wants $4,000 for one of these. With a dulcimer wrench truss rod adjustment. Just saying, I don't want to bust anybody's balls. And then there's a whole big list of symptoms and stupidity and why it wouldn't work. And then it talks about, you know, a really good manual, back bow, forward bow, get your dulcimer wrench out. Bridge adjustments, installation. Pickup height. They basically go through everything, but we got to go down to the other end, and I'll show you why I've lost my shit. In the case with this bass was this wrench and this wonderful manual. This is where the comedy totally begins, because when you open the truss rod cover, it says warning. Read instructions. I've never seen that, but I think more guitar manufacturers should put that in there. So if we look closely, I think what happened is that it used to be square, and then someone put a hex thing on it and didn't use that wonderful wrench, and they just chowdered it. All right. That's the bad news. We'll get to the good news. Okay, like I said, you've seen it here, right? Okay, so what I managed to do, there's some other stuff that's happened here with the nut. There's a bit of shim under the nut, and I really didn't want this to turn into a firewood. What I was able to do with a lot of examination and being very careful, like the neck is straight, it's not really bent, and I think the neck relief right now is fine. I got this to actually very carefully
with some pressure and being careful, the truss rod works. This does catch. So, like, okay, hot rod guy there, I'm going to make this right, and then we're not going to fuck with it, okay, anymore, whoever you are. And just a big shout out to Scott, you know, because he screwed himself up. So, you know, he broke his stuff, and I don't even know if he can wipe his own bum at this point, but he said there's no rush on the base because he, you know, in a cast up to his ass, I guess. What am I looking for? I don't know, a base straight edge. What scale is this thing? A Fender scale or a different scale? Yeah, good old Leo got her right. Okay, right now there's a little bit of a backbone in the neck, but I'm not going to touch it because we're going to put strings on it, and it's going to need, I don't want to screw with that at the end, right? Like I said, this bass is old enough and seasoned enough and been around enough. This is from the 90s, I believe, like 95-ish, 2005, 15. Shit, we're approaching 30 years. So if it warped by now, it probably won't be. I detect a pattern. This is, you know, what was the last video? That Breedlove thing where, you know, the poor company did their best to help, you know, those that are helpless. What was my joke? Oh, I'm not saying you're stupid. You just got a lot of bad luck when it comes to thinking. Seems to be a lot of that going around. This is cleaned up really nice. And I got a brand new set of roto sounds for you there, Scott. And also I put a brand new handle on the case that was broken off, probably by the same knucklehead that did whatever they did down at that end. I just put the cover on, don't look there, as long as it plays well, know that you would maybe need a professional, and you can refer to this video later on. I can get it to work, but you have to just have a little finesse. I think that sticker at the other end there in the truss rod cavity there. Warning, you are an idiot. Don't touch this. I don't know. No, I mean, how? I've never seen that. And both my friend Mike and I sort of chuckled and went, you know, maybe they should put that in more guitars. It might help. Well, let's look inside and see if we can fix our O-ring. How's your O-ring? Anybody? My O-ring's pretty good. It could be an issue for some people, especially when your O-ring blows apart like that. Not a good day. Somewhere in my collection of collections, suction pig, thank you. Oh no. Like, you know, it's like the high-tech rotten elastic band with some foam around it and a dead-ass fucking Energizer. Let me find the right wrench. We shall release the output jack and see if I have an O-ring in my O-ring department. Well, screw the O-ring. It's just, what's that do? Nothing. I can just tighten this up. My light skinny wrench, and then we're out of that. The problem with this one is it's 14 millimeter on the back side, and I've seen so many people try and tighten this from the front and bust all the wires off on the inside. This will be fine. That stupid rubber is just stupid. Nice idea, I guess. Probably came with the output jack, so they decided they had to use it, but eventually it just rotted up. Failed. That's not going to move. Everything else seems to be... wait a minute.
Wait a cotton picking minute here. Just wires spinning onto wires. I mean, it's a nice wiring job, nice and tight, but that can't spin. I believe we're good. I believe so. One more little turn. And just because we can, where did that go? Oh, here it is. A little bit of non-permanent lock, blue Loctite. Just a drop. Ink. There you go. That'll never come off. Unless you want it to. New battery, test electronics. Let's get the new strings on it and get this done. The controls need a little help. And once again, the output jacks I hate. Back to the drawing board. Once again, back to hating these output jacks. Oh, and nothing but the best. Alpha pots, really? We're gonna use, after I pull up my pants, compliments of the boys from Down Under. I'm not sure what the material is. This is called a crackle killer. Crackle, spelt with a K. And believe it or not, even my good friend Mike Zimmerman has said, because I gave him some of these to try, and he goes, hey, one of these saved me from pulling all apart a big Gibson, you know, with F-holes, and everything's inside, and we can't tell what's going on and why it doesn't work. And take your favorite contact cleaner, take the crackle killer, and move it in and out. Don't spin it around. You can spin it around when you pull it out. But you guys understand this motion. See all the shit coming out of there? So what happens is the barrel jack, I think that's technically what it's called, the actual barrel gets shit all on it. And that's why it gets an intermittent ground. Oh, baby, baby, baby. I love you big time. And I'm going to spray out the potentiometers as well. See all the crud that comes out of there? I think we'll be okay. Once again, back to the deoxit products. A little dab will do you. Don't be scared. It evaporates really fast. Give these a spin. I mean, for alpha pots, they feel pretty good. Okay, let's plug it in and hope it doesn't make all those shitty noises again. Because it's got like preamplification things and little black squares with mystical shit inside them. Because they didn't want anybody to copy their mystical tone circuit. Okay, what did we get? I think we're rocking now. Sure, that's a blend. Yeah, we're good. Thank you, crackle killer. See, that's all gone. That was all that. Nice work. By request, Roto sounds. Let's get them on and make this thing play. And then we just keep an eye on it. And then if anything changes, then we make sure we're very careful about adjusting the truss rod from now on, right? What's it say at the end? Warning, read instructions. Let me find my dulcimer wrench here. We tuned up the pitch. And once again, this is an old piece of wood. If it's still moving around, it needs to go to the fireplace. So right now, I would maybe just want to tighten that a tiny bit, and I can, but like I said, someone racked it, so now I got to be really careful. So we're going to loosen the strings off half a turn.
because I don't want to fight. Carefully get my dulcimer wrench in there and find what's left of that square and tighten that. Oh my God. And even after much cleaning, output jack needs to be replaced. I don't know if I have one of those, but I will look. If not, we will get one later. But it's screwed. And there's nothing you can do. On a normal switchcraft, you can go in there and you can push the little tabs in so they make better contact. You see what's happened to this? Over time, it's just the insides of just not doing what they need to do, and there's nothing you can do about it. Wow. Make a living replacing all stupid things. I'm believing the deck has got some good straightness, and like I said, if it doesn't change, you know what I mean? I'll get you guys in the movie a little better. If it doesn't change, we're going to be fine. I'm a little concerned about the string height. I think it's one of those ones where these don't go low enough, and this is right. Okay, I got the truss rod adjustment, and I'm pretty sure it's going to stay where it needs to stay. And like I said, it does work, just got to be careful. String height. I often get asked this question. This is not a Fender bass, but it's a Fender scale. What numbers would I use? Probably the Fender numbers. So I'd like to see at the 17th fret 5 64s. That's right where that is. That's sitting at 6, so that's wrong. That one's 5 but more. And the G string, wait for it, she's at 6. Okay, so let's do some adjustment here and get this lined up. And then we're going to revisit this nut where some nut put a shim under the nut, which I don't think needed to be there at all, but we'll find out. String height is good. Let's do pickup height. Bartolini's like an eighth of an inch. It's too close. That one will work. It's a little too far away. Too close. Intonation check. And I already know that this is wrong at the nut. It's really close, but I'm not taking that shim out. There's a couple nut slots that will need to be adjusted. And I gotta find a new output jack. I might have one. I'll look through my stuff. I doubt it. Because every time I buy those, I buy two. Because I know I'm gonna get another job like this in a week, guaranteed. The other thing, I've had this guitar sitting out for days in good humidity. I just wanted to make sure it was what it was. At least it wasn't all whipped and bent. That'll work. Strings to correct. I hit you guys in a movie. Okay, so some of the strings seem all right. What we'd like to see is a maximum 22 thousandths of an inch here. That's probably broaching to max. This, I can wiggle that around in there. Let me find the actual, where's 22? This would be the actual max. There's 18 as well, which really is where I like it. So that's maxed. Well, somebody liked that. I'm not going to touch it. It's in spec. That works, but To me, it seems high. Kind of like the person that fixed this last.
Okay. We're going to get a new output jack. See? Ah, you biatch. Anyhow, once again, let it sit. Check it again. It does play. It's unfortunate that someone, you know, made a mess. But like I said, there's still something there to catch with your dulcimer wrench. I'm without words. Okay. All the links to great things are below in the description. Special shout out always to my patrons. You can become one, and I am there for you, I guarantee, even if I have to get my snow shovel out. What else? Subscribe, join the Facebook group, Twitter me, get a Day's World of Fun Stuff sticker for Christmas, get a Penny Black CD for Christmas. Who knew, huh? Have Christmas, happy Thanksgiving and all that stuff, and let's just move forward and be safe and be good to each other. Cheers.